All right, ladies and gentlemen, Rafi Chowdhury here with RafiChowdhury.com. And today we're going to be doing a little bit of a study or analysis, so to speak, and dig a little bit deeper into a very interesting topic, which is chess queen quotes, or rather more shortly term, just like chess quotes about chess and things of people at chess masters and different chess players have said over the years. And we're going to be researching some of them, looking at some of them, and just try to figure out like what they mean and what's the value behind some of these things. So here we go. Let's get started. So I went ahead and did some homework, and I went ahead and Googled chess queen quotes. And so this is kind of what came up. So let's start with the spruce.com. Let's look at what they have to share with us about chess queen quotes. Loading, taking a long time to load. So in chess, obviously, there's quotes have been said by many grandmasters and those type of people. And again, looking at some of those quotes, if you really understand what they were trying to say, will significantly improve your game. Like I did an article recently, like 13 chess tips by Magnus Carlsen. And in fact, you know, one of his tricks was to just to drink like healthy things like orange juice and stuff like that during his games. So his brain, you know, keeps sharp. His focus is sharp, and it does help. It does help to try kind of study and understand some of these things. So here we go. Inspirational chess quotes from the masters. Number one: tactics flow from a superior position, by Bobby Fischer. And what Fischer was basically trying to say is that if you have a really solid positional understanding of the game, like you understand the game from a very positional aspect, you know what, you know, fianchetto positions in this type of opening makes sense, or you understand that, you know, let's see, having a passed pawn in the certain types of end games is important, then a lot of the times the tactics will tend to favor you. If you have a solid position, all your pieces are developed, you're attacking the center, you're pointing them towards a king, your bishops are open, you're just positioned well, tactics tend to also favor those kind of positions. And it just kind of naturally happens that way. All right. Number two, even the laziest king flees wildly in the face of a double check. And this just kind of shows you the power of a double check. Double check is whenever two pieces basically attack the king at the same time. So the typical scenario where that happens is where you have, you know, two pieces that like one piece is basically checking the king, but the same, you know, a piece of your, one of your own pieces is actually blocking the check. So when you move that piece gives check, and the piece that was behind it also gives check to the king. And that's called double check. In those cases, there's only one thing you can do, and that's moving your king. So just always be aware of these double checks because they're very, very forcing moves in chess. Chess is a fairy tale of 1001 blunders. Obviously, in chess, we make tons of mistakes all throughout the game. And chess is very similar to life in the sense that we make tons of mistakes in life too, but we don't really realize we're making these mistakes, and they just kind of happen, and we just kind of see like the outcome of it, right? We think we made only one big mistake, but really we might have made many, many smaller mistakes along the way. And chess is that's very obvious. And if you look at if a master comes and analyzes the game of a amateur player, they can easily point out that, well, you could have done this better, you could have done that better, and you actually made mistakes all throughout the game. It's usually not just one mistake that loses the game, but a string of mistakes that we've been making that slowly leads to it, oftentimes. So that's really what this quote is all about. The winner of the game is the player who makes the next to last mistake, and that's pretty much like what I was just saying, is that if your opponent makes the second to last mistake, that's it. And you capitalize off of that, you win the game, and you've gotten it, you know? So it's very important not only to avoid mistakes, but to also capitalize off of your opponent's mistakes as well. When you see a good move, look for a better one. So that's a very good quote. Actually, I really like this one because they're, you know, yes, we find some good moves, and if you're an expert or master strength player, obviously you're going to be finding a lot of the good moves naturally. But just keep looking, because there might be something better than what you're thinking. Just don't give it, you know, don't be so quick to make a quick move, because again, there's tactics and stuff like that can follow from it. But more importantly, try to see if you can find the best possible move in a position that puts the most pressure on your opponent. Pawns are the soul of chess, and that's very true, because without your pawns, you know, that's kind of like the skeleton of the entire game, and pawns can really make or break your entire game. So think of pawns as very important pieces, and they will become more important as the game progresses. A lot of times, you know, near the end game, pawns really matter a lot. So the pawn structure ultimately determines, you know, how your end game is going to end up being. So just try to make sure, try to keep your pawn structure solid. You know, try to don't have bad structures and things like that. And just really value the pawns, because they really can make a difference. Alpha variations, which is calculator and tournament game. And so basically it's important, you know. Though the remaining of the quote says, turn out to be completely superfluous. Unfortunately, no one knows in advance which half. So pretty much it's important to analyze all of your candidate moves, not just the ones that interest you. Tillman reminds that while it's tempting to take shortcuts, there's no way of knowing whether you're skipping over the critical line until you take a look at everything. So a lot of times we get really sidetracked when we're analyzing the position. We start looking at sidelines and stuff like that and see if we can make things work. And we just end up, you know, diverting from the main solution to any kind of situation. And so it's really important that you stay on track when you calculate out different variations. The hardest game to win is a one game. And this is very, very true in a lot of cases, because it takes only one bad, you know, move to lose a game, but it takes a string of good moves to win one. So even if you think the game is in your favor, it's very hard to win that, ultimately finish, you know, put the cap on it. And that's because it's very hard to come up with the perfect string of moves, you know, to end, bring the game to an end, especially when your opponent is, you know, is playing a perfect defense and then finding ways to hold things together. So don't give up until you've actually won the game and shaken hands. Just keep fighting as if the game is nowhere near over yet. Don't lose focus, pretty much. Number 9, a sacrifice is best refuted by accepting it. So lots of chess players will just give away a piece, and you will be like, wow, free piece. I don't, you know, why did he give that away? Well, obviously you should look to see if there's any dangers of, you know, taking the capture. But if you search and you see no reason why you shouldn't capture the piece, go ahead and take it. Just accept it and make your opponent prove to you that this actually works. That's often a much better approach than just being unsure and thinking, I'm not sure why, so I'm going to leave it as it is. Don't leave it as it is. Just take it. Many have become chess masters. No one has become the master of chess. That's actually an interesting quote. This quote is yet another reminder that there's always room for improvement in our chess game. There's nothing we do perfectly. And chess always provides us with more to learn, study. The incredible depth of this game suggests that even the mightiest computers will have plenty more to figure out for decades, centuries, and perhaps even millennia. So tons of people are chess masters and they're really good at it, but nobody has figured it all out. Chess is still an unsolved puzzle, unsolved mystery, and there's always going to be new variations and lines and things like that are coming out in a game of chess. That's it for you guys for today. Hope you enjoyed this video series, and I hope you like the structure of making that I'm, you know, making these videos, kind of like looking at some things that you guys are, you know, often searching for in Google and asking questions about. And just kind of doing an in-depth study analysis, looking into what other people have posted about it. Just kind of talking it through and just us, you know, researching together and making it fun. Thanks, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Rafi Chowdhury checking out.